Very early, one morning at the bottom of the garden, Bill and Ben, the flower pot men, were playing Jack in the Boxes.
Oh, flubber-dub.
Flubber-dub.
Flubber-dub. Oh, flubber-dub.
As Little Weed was still fast asleep, they were playing very quietly.
Flubber-dub.
Bill and Ben decided that they'd better play their game somewhere else. They didn't want to waken Weed. As they looked at her, the flowerpot men thought that such a beautiful creature as Weed should have a more beautiful place to live.
Oh, flubber-blubber-dib-hop.
Oh, yuck, flubber-lub.
Bill decided they should ask someone what to do. They decided that Slow Coach the Tortoise might help them.
What's going on? Really? It's you two. I might have known. A more beautiful place to live? Weed? What's wrong with the place as it is? No, I've no idea. Anyway, now I'm up. I want my breakfast.
Bill and Ben thought they'd ask the garden gnome if he had any bright ideas. But he didn't have any ideas at all. He was made of concrete.
Flubber-dub.
Bill had seen something. He thought it was a piece of sky. Maybe it had floated down in the night, he said. Bill thought it was just the very thing they needed for Weed. Her very own piece of sky. Now that would smarten up her corner of the garden. Of course, it wasn't a piece of sky at all. It was a piece of mirror that had been reflecting the sky.
Oh, God, flubber. Oh, you cool. Oh, I don't want to kill you.
Hello, you two. What are you up to? A piece of the sky. But the sky doesn't fall. And it's really, really high up. Too high up even to touch. You'll never get a peaceful Weed.
Sky!
Bill and Ben decided that if the sky was so high up, they might be able to get a piece if they climbed to the top of the fence. But the fence was very high too. Bill and Ben weren't sure how they were going to get to the top. Bill had had an idea. He'd seen some string in the tool shed and some other bits and pieces that might help them in their hunt for a piece of sky. Slow Coach was still looking for his breakfast.
Those flower pot men, too much energy for their own good, if you ask me.
It wasn't long before Ben found the string and Bill found a very useful looking nail. Bill found a piece of cloth that he thought would be just the thing for wrapping their piece of sky in. Now they had everything they needed to collect a piece of sky. They told Slow Coach so, too.
I had a flubber look on quite a slug a chug. I don't care about that. I just want my breakfast.
Bill and Ben told Slow Coach he'd have to hurry. If he didn't find his breakfast soon, it'd be time for lunch.
Flubbadub.
Flubbadub.
At last, the flowerpot men reached the top of the fence. They'd never seen so much of the world.
Flubber! Flubber lob!
A flubber lob? Huh? A flubber lob?
They even saw Slowcoach. He still hadn't found his breakfast. But even though they were a long way up, they still couldn't reach the sky.
Hello? What are you two doing all the way up here? The sky? You'd have to fly as high as high to touch the sky. I don't think even I could get you all the way up to the sky. All right. But I'm not making any promises, mind. Right. Grab hold of a leg each. Chocks away!
Bill and Ben were quite amazed. Everything below them seemed so small. But high as they were, they seemed to be no nearer to the sky.
Steady on down there. If you keep wriggling about like that, you're going to fall.
At last, a spot of breakfast. Oh, yes. And not before time. My tummy is rumbling like a...
Poor Slowcoach. Bill and Ben came to land right on top of his breakfast.
Oh, no! Look what you've been and gone and done now.
Hello. Have I missed something?
Only these two nitwits ruining me breakfast. That's all.
What have you two been up to?
What a funny
And Bill and Ben explained how they'd been trying to catch a piece of sky to cheer up the corner of the garden where little Weed lived.
Oh, you are a silly pair. Why would I need this blaze cheering up? You do all the cheering up a weed would ever need.
It was still early in the day, but Bill and Ben were ready for a sleep.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long.